since death is a hostile environment, animals definitely have to take it to the next level. It clearly shows here in the Sonoran Desert where animals are in constant survival. Right now, competition is about to begin. Wild mustangs, the wild horses of the Wild West. Here, they roam freely out in the open. Even the foals see it as an opportunity to stretch their legs and exercise them while playing. However, food shortages is getting low. Soon, there won't be much grass left, and someone has to leave the herd on a treacherous journey. However, no leader has been decided yet. And now, competition arrives. Two stallions will clash out to see who will become the top horse around here. The winner takes leadership. The two stare eye to eye, waiting for the first move. There's constant biting, pushing, and shoving in each of these battles. And even some deadly kicks. one stallion maintains leadership. While the other has better luck next time. He will lead the herd on a journey that will feel harsh, but since he's the leader, he knows he can accomplish anything. Desert is like a sad habitat to many people with fewer grass and trees. But they weren't so harsh, they could transform into a new paradise that's even better than sand. This is the rise of grasslands. Here in Africa, the savanna is one of the most recognized habitats on the planet. Here, there are many grass with fewer trees, but this holds an astonishing number of life that it can support. A herd of zebras and wildebeest almost completed their great migration and almost on their way to the new grassy paradise. The Mara River, the final challenge. It looks just like a plain old river. Should be easy to cross. However, the stallion remembers something. This is not just a river. This is Crocodile River. Now, crocodiles have been waiting for the Great Migration a long time, and they know to tradition. When her tries to cross the river, they'll be waiting with open jaws. Now they wait for the first to cross. No member wants to be the first victim. But with an act of bravery, the stallion takes the lead. Seeing this, the rest of the herd joins in. The crocodiles move in, while Hood keeps going with all their might. The stallion is the first to make it, while the rest is lagging a bit. There's one casualty. But the rest survived. And now it's time to meet their new home. This is truly the new paradise the Savannah can support. The Serengeti is home over 1 million wildebeests and zebras and antelopes. Well, the herd this big, they have enough grass to go around. Even for the young. However, predators are attracted. A cheetah. But he's not alone. He has a pail. But also a third member. And they refer to themselves as brothers. Unlike female cheetahs, who usually solitary hunters, brothers usually hunt together, taking things about anything about their size, even bigger than gazelles. Today, they're hunting for something special, their favorite. Outer wildebeests are tough, but they're sure in for a challenge. One of the brothers must get real close in order for the chase to start. When your prey is close, it's time. Chaos everywhere. the butter locks on to the target. An outer wall be this size, maybe 2x4, but a takedown alone. Luckily, help is on the way. Now, they must watch the guy to take down their prize. Now that's teamwork. On a hot day in the savannah, a herd of African elephants know what to do to beat the heat. It's to go in the water for a swim. Calves usually are ready to go for swimming yet because of fear of water. But others are just having too much fun to remember. If swimming isn't enough, there's another way to cool off. Spring yourself and others too. Taking a bath also helps too. Spraying yourself is like taking a shower for elephants. the calf, seeing all the fun the others are having, decides to give it a go too. So, he takes his footsteps into the water. Well done. You made a new friend. Now that's beautiful.